It looks like Sierra Space's Dream Chaser will be finally launching on SpaceX's Starship Super Heavy. These delays are just insane. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started.
Sierra Space's highly anticipated Dream Chaser spacecraft has once again faced a delay in its debut mission, marking another setback in its long and ambitious path toward space operations. Originally envisioned as a versatile reusable spaceplane capable of carrying high both cargo and crew to low Earth orbit, Dream Chaser was slated to make its first flight to the International Space Station, ISS, under NASA's Commercial Resupply Services, CRS-2 contract. However, the company has now confirmed that the maiden mission, named Tenacity, will no longer dock with the ISS as originally planned, and will instead demonstrate its capabilities in a free flight test to orbit and back. This change reflects both technical and logistical challenges that have emerged as Sierra Space attempts to transition the Dream Chaser from development to active flight service. The Dream Chaser program, based on a design lineage dating back to NASA's HL-20 lifting body concept, has long stood out for its airplane-like approach to spaceflight. Unlike traditional capsules, such as SpaceX's Dragon or Boeing's Starliner, Dream Chaser is designed to land on conventional runways, offering a gentler reentry for sensitive cargo and a rapid turnaround between missions. Yet, despite its potential, the program's journey has been marked by years of engineering complexity, regulatory hurdles, and shifting mission goals. The latest announcement adds another chapter to this story of perseverance and adaptation, as Sierra Space works to finalize testing and immigration ahead of the long-awaited launch. One of the main factors contributing to the delay involves the integration of Dream Chaser with its expendable cargo module, called Shooting Star. This module provides power, propulsion, and storage space for the spacecraft and will be jettisoned before re-entry. The combined system has required extensive testing to ensure structural, thermal, and aerodynamic compatibility. Reports suggest that Sierra Space has been conducting vibration, acoustic, and thermal vacuum tests at NASA facilities to simulate launch and orbital conditions. Despite the progress, engineers reportedly discovered issues that required additional refinements, prompting a decision to push the mission timeline further. While the spacecraft is now nearly complete, the company and NASA have agreed that a non-docking orbital demonstration is the best way to ensure reliability before committing to ISS integration. The first Dream Chaser mission will launch aboard a United Launch Alliance Vulcan Centaur rocket from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. The Vulcan rocket itself has experienced delays due to upper stage engine qualification and certification requirements, which have cascaded down to impact Sierra Space's schedule. Originally targeted for 2023, the mission was later postponed to 2024 and is now tentatively expected in 2025, though the company has not confirmed an exact date. Once launched, Tenacity will spend several days in orbit, testing its autonomous navigation, thermal control, communication systems, and re-entry capabilities before gliding back to a runway landing at NASA's Kennedy Space Center Shuttle Landing Facility. This flight is expected to validate the spacecraft's reusability and precision landing systems, critical elements that could distinguish Dream Chaser in the competitive field of commercial space logistics. NASA's decision to allow Dream Chaser to skip docking on its first mission reflects a pragmatic approach to ensuring mission safety. The ISS docking process involves complex guidance and verification protocols that must meet strict safety standards to avoid any collision or debris risk. By focusing the initial mission solely on demonstrating orbital performance, Sierra Space can gather essential data to finalize certification for future cargo runs. Once approved, Dream Chaser will begin delivering supplies, experiments, and potentially returning materials from the ISS with greater flexibility and a faster turnaround time than current capsule-based systems. NASA continues to express confidence in Sierra Space's long-term role in its resupply architecture, emphasizing that technical delays are a normal part of developing a new spacecraft. Behind the scenes, Sierra Space has been expanding its infrastructure and partnerships to support the Dream Chaser's operational future. The company's large test campaign, in collaboration with NASA and its parent company, Sierra Nevada Corporation, has involved hundreds of engineers and technicians. In addition, Sierra Space is positioning the Dream Chaser as part of a broader ecosystem that includes its proposed Orbital Reef Commercial Space Station, co-developed with Blue Origin. In this vision, Dream Chaser would serve not only NASA, but also private customers seeking to transport experiments, cargo, or even passengers to low Earth orbit destinations. This aligns with NASA's goal of encouraging commercial spaceflight providers to replace government-built vehicles as the ISS nears retirement. Still, the latest delay has sparked questions about long-term funding and launch logistics. With the Vulcan Centaur still maturing, some analysts speculate that Sierra Space might explore alternative launch options in the future. One particularly intriguing possibility is leveraging SpaceX's Starship as a heavy-lift launcher for Dream Chaser. Theoretically, Starship could deploy Dream Chaser into low Earth orbit, either as a payload or within a specialized deployment bay, offering greater flexibility and potentially lower costs once Starship becomes operational. The enormous payload capacity of Starship could allow Sierra Space to launch fully integrated Dream Chaser systems or multiple modules simultaneously, expanding mission possibilities. While no official discussions have been confirmed, such a partnership could bridge two major commercial players in the post-ISS era, reshaping the economics of orbital transport. If Starship were ever used as a launch platform for Dream Chaser, it could also have ripple effects for SpaceX's Dragon program. Currently, Dragon dominates NASA's cargo and crew missions, but as newer vehicles like Dream Chaser mature, competition could intensify. Dragon's design, optimized for capsule-based reentry, offers proven dependability but less flexibility in landing and reusability compared to a spaceplane. Dream Chaser's ability to land on a runway and be rapidly refurbed could attract future contracts, especially as NASA and commercial entities look for faster and more efficient turnaround times. However, given SpaceX's aggressive innovation pace and Starship's looming capabilities, Dragon may evolve toward specialized missions, perhaps focusing more on crewed operations, while Starship handles heavy cargo and deep space logistics. In that future scenario, Dream Chaser could serve as a complementary niche vehicle, offering a unique combination of precision landing, reusability, and versatility that continues the legacy of the space shuttle in a modern, cost-effective form.
Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.